Hey everybody, it's Mark. It's September 10th, and I am back in the forest today. Came to bring a whole bunch of groceries for my friends. It was really cold this morning, so leads me to believe that we're gonna have a fast, cold, early approaching winter. So I'm going to be bringing them corn and apples and so forth during the season, so that I can help them with their calorie chase through the fall here, coming into winter. I'm going to go ahead. I always get lost trying to find the initial route to that hidden area. It's always a trick. Check this out. A little gathering of sticks, and already I'm starting to see something's been traipsing through here pretty big. I think I'm on the right route here. Kind of hard to traverse down through here to remember the right way. I think I'm on the right path here. In fact, it really isn't a path. You have to traipse through all this brush and everything to find it. There's no trail. Leads back into the area I'm going to, which is where the little stick structure area is that they like to hide out in. Spent a lot of time in meditation last night, just kind of setting up visuals that I was going to be coming, bearing gifts, and here's one of the structures over here, up here. This one is a little bit different. This is kind of like a precursor to the other area. Check the soil here. But this is one of the little hideouts that they like to gather in. And it's been torn up inside here. A little bit of pine needles have been shifted around. As you can see, there's sticks they leave inside here. But this is one of the first structures that you come across before heading that way. We gotta cut through all this brush and so forth, all of those boulders, to get to that hidden area. But this is one of the little structures here that they can kind of overlook people, watch people, see who's working the trail, which most people, they work up along over here. The other side of all this brush down there is the trail that leads up, hiking trail. So they're always off trail here. So I'm gonna see if I can find some prints. Just to give you an idea, this little lean shelter that they built in here. It's pretty cool. See that. Now of course this, it could be human made, but it's very unorthodox. You know, it's one of those things. Here we have a very large tree, a very large log, a tree that's been knocked over here. As you can see, it's been set against this other smaller trees here, kind of wedged in there. And then it comes down into this little debris type shelter here. And again, it's not a complete shelter, so It's one of those things, on a guess. This is actually the precursor that led me to the other area. I knew I was onto something here when I found this one. So, I'm gonna try and head over this way and see what we come up with. I'm gonna circle back around here. It's really, really dry today. So, chances of finding any prints is not very good. I can see the ground's really been torn up though, so from last time, so either humans or they or the game has been traipsing through here since the last time I came through. Nice and quiet today. Way get over here. And I can feel them. I can feel them being watched. I kind of whooped at them though for a good while before I came in into the park. As you can see, there's overlooking eastern Colorado, east of where I'm at. So see all of that. They have run up all of that. It's just thick with pine forests everywhere around here. But up here, you know, they have the tactical advantage being up along the canyon, you know, especially with the caves and so forth. Let's see. Yikes, it's really thick. I'm just trying to remember the easiest way to cut through here. I think it was up here. I'll try getting over there. Again, this place that I was, that I found on the 27th, is really hidden. It's really hard to get to. Here we go. See, as you can see, I'm just completely surrounded by brush. See where I'm heading. Okay. Yikes. Okay, something's been traipsing through here. A lot of tracks. Okay, it looks like I'm going to be coming up on the secondary structure. That first one is back down the hill there where I just came from. And then we come up and I come to a little clearing over here. This actually is a little gifting rock over here where this opens up in a meadow that I've used before. They used to like to gather sticks and rocks over here and put them on top of this rock. Now, last time I came, there was a whole bunch of sticks on top of the rock and it looks like they've been gathered. Okay, yeah, they've definitely been up here because I see two sticks that weren't here last time. See this little grouping here on top of this boulder? They leave these sticks here for whatever reason that I haven't figured out yet. I think they like to sit up here on top of this rock, but this stick right here, it's on top of this boulder here, was not here last time. In fact, it was leaning against this rock upright, so it's been moved. Definitely been moved here. And you can see, look at the formation here. We got an axe of some sort. What they're pointing at, I guess if we were to use it as a directional marker, it's pointing off to the over in that general area down there. But it looks like they've definitely been hanging out up here since the 27th. So, they've been doing something up here. Not sure what. But that's pretty interesting. Pretty significant find for me, actually. Okay, just trying to make our way. We're gonna be, I'd say we're about, maybe about 50 yards. 50 or 60 yards from entering in that area. Light breeze. I wish we could get a stronger one though. I thought it was so cold this morning. I thought it would be cooler, but it's pretty hot already. Get over here. Great. Shucks. I have to kind of climb up this boulder here to get to the area. there's another one. Let's see if I can get a different shot of it. It's kind of hard to tell with that sun. Okay, there's the cave. So I've just entered the area again. Something has dismantled most of that structure that was here. It's been torn down. Well, not torn down, but maybe rearranged a little. It's not as significant as it was. So, there's been some activity up here since the 27th. See, it's all been dismantled, or at least changed a little. There was more sticks, and they're gone. So they've definitely been hanging out up here, doing something. It could be humans that have come through here, but again, it's really hard to get through. You saw the kind of brush and so forth that I had to traipse through to come through, so it's not an easy place to find. Alright, let me just kind of get a feel for things. And basically, we are in the gauntlet.
Teyama! Ashukima! Nahilio!
Yep, definitely something over there. Just snapped a stick.
It's me! I brought you some gifts! I brought you some apples.
So, I knew it. I knew I would hear something over there. Something snapped a twig. So I'm gonna take a look around here a little bit and just see what's been going on. See, all those sticks, they're gone. So they have completely dismantled it. There was probably three times the amount of debris and sticks on that shelter there. See, it's all been stacked, kind of like firewood. But there was more here. More here to the shelter, or a fence post is what it is. Really interesting. See, there's dirt all over the stick. See, it's like been used for digging. The X in front of the cave is gone too. Wow, this is really neat because things have changed in just a matter of a week. the axe. It's the large stick that was laid across this, marking the entrance to this grave, or cave, I'm sorry, is gone. So definitely some activity's been going on. Now, this is where I'm standing last time. And as you can see, where our guy was peeking at me, just down over the rock behind this, or this ridge behind this cliff. So that's where we're gonna head right now, so that we can make sure that that wasn't any type of trick or of light or anything. Once I kind of survey the entire area, I will kind of start the process of leaving their gifts. Brought a ton of apples and some corn. Okay. Again, here's the sticks all gathered here. I can hear some movement up here. Yeah. All right, let me get my bearings. So, standing up on top of the hill, I was pointing down here. Tree is over here. So, right here, see this rock? Got this little sticks here. This is the tree, right here. This is the area, because if you look, I was standing up there pointing down here, coming this way. As you can see, if you were to hide behind this boulder and look up, you could just duck. And so this is the tree right here, see? So here's the tree. And this would be me. I'm squatting down right now, peeking up, kind of peeking behind this tree. And this is where I caught him. And see, there's no cave or any type of crevice. It's just open bush here that could have fooled the eye, could have tricked the eye. Have a fresh little tree break right here, right behind the tree. A little branch break. Right there. Okay. So see, as I was coming up the hill from down in the valley where I'm going to be heading, it could have just followed me up, right up, ducked behind this rock and everything. As I'm standing up there on the ridge, pointing the camera down here. So it wasn't a trick of shadow, it wasn't a trick of light. Let's see if I can get a better shot. See? That's where he was, right here, peeking around this tree. Interesting. Let's kind of work our way down the valley here. See, I love it when you go back to reinvestigate things and you find out that it wasn't a trick of light or shadow, that you were right on target. Makes this all worth it, really. There's the log that was used in the axe way up on the hill. Right here. definitely cold. That teepee structure was so well hidden, though, back here. It's going to be hard to find it. I'm kind of moving downhill. And actually, I needed to be heading kind of up towards the... Okay, there's the other structure over here. I got a new tree break or a new lean over here also. Looks like they've been messing with this too. Ground's all torn up.